And thank you, Madam Chair. I am honored to speak today to urgently address the detrimental impact of militarization on Indigenous peoples in Vietnam, particularly the Khmer Krom, the Indigenous peoples of the Mekong Delta. The forced military conscription imposed on young Khmer Krom men subjects them to injustice and discrimination. The tragic case of Huynh Chung, who mysteriously died while serving in the Vietnamese Army in November 2019, highlights the urgent need to address the treatment of Indigenous peoples within the military system. His family's distressing experience of unauthorized body operations further underscores the need for action. Furthermore, the Vietnamese government's tactics of confiscating ancestral farmlands through militarization poses a grave threat to the livelihoods, cultural heritage, and human rights of Indigenous communities, including the Montagnards in the Central Highlands and the Khmer Krom people in the Mekong Delta. This exploitation of land law, which designates all land as government property, requires immediate attention. In light of these pressing concerns, we appeal for the following recommendations. One, urge Vietnam to establish a law that respects the rights of Indigenous peoples and prohibits forced military conscription. The shrinking Indigenous population as a result of assimilation policies necessitates the protection of their cultural integrity and self-determination. Granting Indigenous individuals the voluntary choice to join the military will honor their rights and preserve their unique identities. Two, call upon Vietnam to revise the land law, putting an end to confiscating Indigenous lands for military purposes. The manipulation of the land law undermines Indigenous communities' livelihoods and cultural heritage and human rights. It is crucial to safeguard land rights and ensure Indigenous peoples have rightful ownership and control over their own ancestral lands. Thank you, Akun.